So Huey Lewis is the final crush in this list, and it's for a good reason. I wanna love you all over. Okay, other than that, I didn't get into him back in high school or anything because of some dumb list on VH1. The most awesomely bad songs.
It takes a lot of hard work for a band to win over a rock audience, but whipping people into a frenzy by naming the city they live in, that's cheating.
And because adults on TV were saying it, it was bad.
You can't help but think, he's trying to get the people in those cities to like this, isn't he?
Yeah, maybe you should have watched your own Behind the Music episode.
Flush with success, the news hit the road for a national tour, winning fans and finding inspiration in clubs and cities across the country.
And I said, you know what, guys? The heart of rock and roll is in Cleveland. And I said, hey, wait a minute, that's a good idea for a song. And three guys went, the heart of rock and roll is in Cleveland? You gotta be crazy.
I didn't want to be uncool, so I very wrongly dismissed Huey Lewis in the news. Also, I was 15. Can I just go back in time and punch myself in the face? They are so good.
If there is a heart of rock and roll, it would have stopped when it heard this song.
Completely ignoring the harmonica solo. Oh my gosh, this list still makes me mad. We didn't start the fires on it, too.
Can the entire history of the 20th century be crammed into a 4-minute, 50-second pop song? The answer, of course, is no.
The answer is yes. That's what I like about him. I like his raspy voice. She's giving it all up for love. Oh, she's giving it up, giving it up, giving it all up for love. He can play harmonica. Oh, and yeah, he's really, really hot, too. Their videos are also so much fun. And sit back and enjoy the videos for a second, because you're in for some delicious 80s cheese. Jeez, Huey, just let me have my coffee. Oh my gosh, they're all cute. I just want to take them home with me. Or at least get one of those sweet members only jackets. I wish that were me. She's got a tattoo. What is he checking to see if he has one too? Actually, the first way I learned one of their songs was from Sesame Street. It's hip to be a swell. So hip to be. It's hip to be a swell. So hip to be. It's hip to be. And up until high school, I always thought the name of the song was called It's Hip to Be a Square. He also sang the opening song for Oliver and Company. I told you I'd get back to that. Now it's always once upon a time in New York City. It's a big old battle, tough old town, it's true. Speaking of Disney, he's also on Puppy Dog Pals. Go and find yourself a four-leaf clover. Go find one and bring it back to Bob. Like, I need another excuse to watch Disney Junior. I really hope Huey gets better, because, like, I'll be the first in line to see them. So yeah, lesson learned here. Don't listen to adults on TV who try to tell you what's cool. I realize I'm contradicting myself a bit here, but yeah. Huey, sorry I missed out so early, but you're awesome.
Well, that's all I got, but don't worry, you'll hear from me soon.
Toss me the moon, because I've got a shine. I'm climbing a cloud and calling it mine. You'll pardon my hate, I've no time to wait. You're gonna hear from me. Heaven smile from the blue above me. I'm heaven's child. Listen, world, you're gonna love me. I'm on my way, cause I've got it. Raise up my flag, begin my parade. My comet's on fire, I've gotta go higher. It sounds kinda crazy, but take it from Daisy.
got it from Agnes. She got it from Jim. We all agree it must have been Louise who gave it to him. Now she got it from Harry, who got it from Marie. And everybody knows that Marie got it from me. Giles got it from Daphne. She got it from Joan. She picked it up in Ireland, a kiss in the Blarney Stone. Pierre gave it to Sheila, who must have brought it there. He got it from Francois and...